Hey guys, in this video I'm going to do another single cell RNA-Seq tutorial similar to my last video. In my last video I went over how to do cell type labeling, and I'm going to include that as part of this video, but this video is going to be on how to do integrated analysis in Seurat. In my particular example, I'm going to integrate across two species, and basically I'm going to do this whole analysis and go over the R code step by step. So this is going to be an R tutorial video, but I think I'm going to do it a little bit differently than I did my last video since the code is a little long. I've already published it to RPubs, so it's already publicly available. And I think what I'll do is I'll just go over, and the video will be going over the RPubs documentation since it already has all the graphs and everything printed out. So in this particular video, I'm going to go over how to do something called integrated analysis or anchoring in Seurat. And basically what that is if you have single cell RNA-Seq data for multiple conditions or multiple time points or multiple species, for example, and you want to compare or integrate across different Seurat objects, you can do that using what's called anchoring in Seurat 3.0. So for this particular data set, I'm comparing across two species, human and mouse, and basically I have single cell RNA-Seq data for the human, mouse separately, and then in Seurat I can do a combined analysis. I can produce a combined t-SNE plot like this that integrates the two species, and you can see the similarities and differences. And then you can also do cluster labeling. And at the bottom, you can also produce what are called frequency tables to show you the frequencies of the different cell types across species or across conditions. And this analysis is using, again, a publicly available data set. It's similar to the one I did in the previous video. So I'm using publicly available data from the Allen Institute again, and this time I'm using the human and mouse data. And this is single cell RNA-Seq data from the lateral geniculate nucleus and the equivalent dorsal lateral geniculate complex in the mouse. So let's go ahead and get started with the video. I'm basically just going to be explaining what all this code does, and also I will put a lot of links to everything in the description box below. So there's a paper on how Seurat integrates objects, and I'll put a link to that. I'll put a link to the publicly available data set, and I'll put a link to the R code. Let's go ahead and get started with the tutorial. The first thing I do is basically analyze each individual species. So the first part, I do preprocessing and importing of data for the human single cell RNA-Seq data, and I basically just do normal analysis as if it's one species that I'm comparing, and I create a t-SNE plot for just the human, and I do even cell type labeling like I showed how to do in the last video for just the human, and I do the same thing for the mouse. I do that here. So everything above this line is for the human, and everything below this line is for the mouse. And the only thing that's different, or the only thing that I'm going to add as well for each individual subject, is I'm going to add metadata here, and I'm going to add metadata for each Seurat object that I create about the species. So I'm creating two Seurat objects, one for the human and then one for the mouse, and I'm adding metadata to each Seurat object of what species it is here. So for this part, I do an @meta.data. There might be another way of doing this in Seurat 3.0, but this does work in Seurat 3.0, adding the metadata this way. And I just call, instead of calling it species, I call it protocol. So I say this Seurat object protocol is equal to human. And then I do the same thing for mouse, except I call it mouse. And I do that here. So at this line here above integration section, I will have created two Seurat objects, one called pbmc_mouse and another one called pbmc_human. And so I'll have two Seurat objects that are basically individually analyzed. And then the next step, I want to do the integration. So for integration, I'm going to create a combined object and use the function called merge. And then I'm going to merge my two Seurat objects. And I'm going to call the first object mouse and the second object human. And this is being separated by the group or category protocol or species. For this next part, I'm doing a split object and splitting it by protocol, and the split is going to split into human and mouse. So this code here is basically just creating an integrated object and then saying if I want to to split this integrated object, I want to split it by the two species that I created from each individual analysis. And then I'm going to do the anchoring step. So the anchoring step is the integration, the actual integration step in Seurat 3.0. The previous versions of Seurat did integrated analysis using canonical correlation analysis, but actually I've tried the old version and it doesn't work very well. So I do recommend using the 3.0 version, which is anchoring, which works a lot better. And this is basically saying to find what are called anchoring points between the two species as listed in the reference list. So we're passing through the two subjects or the two species, and we're finding anchoring points using the first 30 dimensions given here. So that runs, and basically it finds integrated points or anchors, and then it does filtering, and in the end we have 1,909 anchors across the two species. And then basically this next line of code will analyze the integrated object. So what we're doing is scaling the data, running PCA, running a t-SNE plot, and then plotting the t-SNE plot. And this group by command is saying to split or show the differences in the groups based on protocol, which again we're labeling as human and mouse. So when you actually plot this, it shows a t-SNE plot that is separated by human in red and mouse in blue. So this P1 code is one way of plotting the integrated object, which is separated by species or by protocol. But after you run this analysis, you can also run this code, which is P2, and this plot will show you the integrated object, but now it's being separated by clusters. So Seurat found clusters, and now it's labeling and separating the dots according to clusters. And then this next code shows the two t-SNE plots plotted side by side, and this one again is separated by species, and then this one separated by Seurat clusters. And then in the next part of the code that I show here, I just show some examples, and I showed this in the previous video of how you can do cluster cell type labeling. So I'm just using some genetic markers to determine for the integrated object what I want the cell IDs to be, and so I do that using feature plots mainly in this next part of the code. And then in this next section, I assign the cell IDs that I want for my different clusters, and basically I'm IDing four different types of cell types for the integrated cluster, and basically it's showing here that I found four different cell types across the integrated object, and that I'm using this to label them in the t-SNE plots. And so for this next part of the code, I'm plotting the combined integrated object that's been separated by Seurat clusters that have been ID'd. And this next part of the code is just showing the two t-SNE plots. One is separated by species type, and the next is separated by cell ID type. And for this final part of the code, you can create a proportion table or a frequency table to compare differential gene expressions across species, for example. So if you want to know what percentage of a certain cell type, so let's say glutamatergic neuron, if you want to know if that's predominantly the main cell ID type in humans or in mice, or if you want to compare across cell types, you can do that using this code, and that will plot these two proportions across each other. So this is the four proportions of cell ID types for the human and the four for the mouse. The mouse only has three cell ID types found. And then if you run freak table, it will give you the actual proportion breakdown for human across all the cell ID types and for mouse for all cell ID types. So you can see for this part of the brain, the glutamatergic neuron proportions seem to be similar, and overall there doesn't seem to be a huge difference in cell ID types for this part of the brain for the human and the mouse. And another thing I forgot to mention in the beginning of this video is the reason I can do this integrated analysis across species which have different gene ID names is because I've filtered the data prior to running this analysis. So actually I filtered the data on homologous genes. So I'm not doing a full analysis on the original matrices across the two because the mouse has some genes that the human doesn't have and the human has some genes that the mouse doesn't have. So in order to compare across species, what I did was I just filtered for homologous genes. So in other words, I filtered for genes that are present in both human and mouse or are thought to be, you know, equivalent across species. And I did this filtering prior to the video, so my .cvs files are filtered data. But that's something you would only have to do if you were comparing across species, and I'm not entirely sure how it would affect your data if you didn't filter. And anyway, that's it for this video, and thank you guys for watching.